What is going on, guys? Bridge Fusion here, and today I'm with you for another video, and today's video is going to be the results and my review of WWE Money in the Bank 2020. I am so looking forward to this. It's going to be like no other Money in the Bank pay-per-view in the past. Let's get straight into it. So up first, it is Jeff Hardy versus Cesaro on the Money in the Bank kickoff match. And I've got to say that this was a really, really strong match. I did really enjoy it. Great work from both men. But yes, Jeff Hardy does pick up the win after his swanton to Cesaro. 1-2-3, Jeff Hardy is your winner. Up first on the Money in the Bank show is The New Day versus the Forgotten Sons versus the Lucha House Party versus Miz and Morrison. Hey, hey, ho, ho. In their sense, hey, hey, no, no. No, they don't win the titles. Of course, Big E and Kofi Kingston successfully retain their tag team championships. And it was a really, really good match. Some great spots in that match. If you haven't seen it, it is definitely worth a watch. And it was just an overall, it was a great match. So up next, it was meant to be MVP versus R-Truth. But MVP and R-Truth had this funny little segment together. I've got to admit, I was laughing from start to finish. It was pretty funny. But out comes Bobby Lashley, tells MVP he can take the night off. So he replaces MVP in their match. So now it is Bobby Lashley versus R-Truth. And it was a squash match, and Bobby Lashley does pick up the win. And yeah, picks up the win. Gutted that we didn't see MVP versus R-Truth, if I'm honest. But yeah, Bobby Lashley wins. Up next, it is for the WWE SmackDown Women's Championship, as it is Bayley defending her title up against Tamina. And I've got to admit, I think this is probably Tamina's best match in WWE so far, and I was actually rooting for her. I'm not her biggest fan, I'm not gonna lie, but I was actually rooting for her to win, but we know she's not gonna win, as she didn't anyway. Bayley does retain. I've got to admit, Bayley is just getting better and better as a heel. You just need to watch that match to see how good she is getting. She is insane. She is so good at her role. And yeah, it was a pretty decent match between both women. And Bayley walks out with her title. Up next, it is for the WWE Universal Championship as Braun Strowman defends his title against Bray Wyatt. And yes, it's Bray Wyatt and not The Fiend. And I got to admit, this was a really, really good match. It was like, I think this was probably one of Bray's like greatest like styles of wrestling from him. I've got to admit, he really looked like a powerhouse in front of Braun Strowman. The storytelling between these two, it was just incredible. You just need to see it. And Braun Strowman does pick up the win. Some people might be a bit salty from this, but I think I prefer that Bray Wyatt loses to The Fiend. Losing, just because I think Bray Wyatt's better off losing rather than The Fiend. That's my opinion. It might be the wrong opinion. I don't know. But yeah, Bray Wyatt loses. Braun Strowman is still your WWE Universal Champion. Up next is Drew McIntyre defending his WWE Championship up against Seth Rollins. And I must say, this match is easily the match of the night so far. It was just incredible. Back and forth from both men. Moments you thought Drew was going to win, moments you thought Seth was going to win. Both, like, brought their A game tonight. And Drew McIntyre successfully defends his WWE Championship against Seth Rollins. And wow. Just wow. Up next is the men and women's Money in the Bank ladder match. But first of all, I'm going to talk about the women's side of the Money in the Bank ladder match. And it was amazing. I absolutely loved it. I was like, what the hell is going on at some point? It was really entertaining. It's definitely worth a watch. And I'm absolutely shook that Asuka won. I was really surprised. I Not as much as the men's, though, I will admit that, but we'll talk about that one in a minute. But yeah, Asuka wins. It was a great, great match. She jumped off the balcony as well onto all the other competitors in the women's match. And it was just incredible. It is definitely worth a watch. Very, very entertaining. And finally, we have our men's Money in a Bank ladder match. And I am shook. Not one person seen this coming. Otis is Mr. Money in the Bank. Absolutely no one seen this coming. If you did, no you didn't. Because Otis is Mr. Money in the Bank. I can't stop thinking about it. It was a great match between the men and women. It was insane. The storytelling going on with AJ Styles and The Undertaker, that was incredible. And blimey, Baron Corbin shoving Rey Mysterio and Aleister Black off the corporate headquarters. That was insane. I hope both of them are okay. But wow, I gotta admit, Money in the Bank, wow, it exceeded its expectations. What did you guys think of Money in the Bank? Please tell me in the comment section below. I thought it was absolutely incredible. But yeah, thank you so much for watching the results and my review of the show, guys. Make sure you do check out my Minecraft creation of Money in the Bank in the Performance Center and at WWE HQ, or the link will be in the description down below. But I've been Bridge Fusion, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I really do hope you like this video. Leave a comment and subscribe for more. Peace out, guys.